Ah, the great outside of the hotel world. How you doing, guys? This is Irish Steel, and welcome to Hotel Renovator. Now, I started doing this in my live stream. This is now my lobby. I'm liking the black marble. I really am. And I sort of figured I'd go with like this red geometry pattern and try and keep this rolling. I stole a little bit of the Gatsby look from Diesel, but genuinely, I've tried to make this my own little house. And that is basically to mimic this, so we had a sort of identical thing going on. It's not too bad. So I've got a couple of little bits and pieces to do here. I was sort of trying to figure out how to mimic, but I'm actually liking the fact that it's sort of painted. It breaks it all up, and I'm probably going to go with like the red through the top, because you can't put textures or tiles or anything on ceilings, apparently, even though you can put them in windows. So yeah, I was experimenting with that. Actually, that looked all right to me, and then I couldn't follow through and put it up actually on there as well. So I tried to keep it a bit simple, and I don't know, sort of inspired by the, you know, the like Star Wars. Yeah. All right, so I need to find my paintbrush. Walls, paintbrush. See, you can't. This is what I want to have. I'd love to be able to put like wallpaper patterns on stuff, but I can't put them on ceilings. So you can't do this, can't put ceramics up, has to be painted. So that's a bit of a shame. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint all of this bit red, basically, because that's the color we're going with. It's blending in with this, trying to keep it the same sort of red as well. So that red there we go. Now I'll paint this through, and then I'll get back to you. There we go. All right, cool. So that's the flooring behind the desk done. That all flows quite nicely. The red at the top with the black looks all good. Now, I did forget to put these in, so I actually don't know what I want to do here. I think maybe we'll just do with like a blank. Maybe I don't really want to use marble again. Marble's good if it like it's breaking up big spaces, like, I know, most of this lobby. But I want something, it almost looked like it should be framed in here. So I need to put a marble on the backs here, but this bit here, I don't know. So there is a little trick you can do if you want to sort of make a frame out of something so it looks a little bit, I don't know, different, but not, you know, quite. So the idea is you would paint in what you want around the edges. Now obviously you're going to get left with two bigger frames around the edge. So what you do is you just knock one of the frames out like this, and then it evens it all up. Actually, wallpaper graphics, these are always quite nice. I think we'll go with mountain. I mean, this might actually be quite nice. I've got to go and silence the guests. Yay me. Shut up in there. Oh, also, yeah. So I've got a little bit. During my live stream, I was talking about the decal I used on my wall. So I'll show you the decal after I've cleaned up their mess again. Messy, messy, messy people, these. So the decal on the back of the wall, I thought it looked all right. Looks quite nice and everything else. The downside to this decal is it actually causes a screen tear through the wall. You can't paint over it. You can't do anything with it. The only way to get rid of it is to remove the decal. Now, how did I figure this out? Because I used the same decal in room 103 on the back wall here, and it clips through the bathroom. Now, you can see this clearer if you get there. There you go. See, it clips through. So it doesn't stop at the wall. You have to physically try and match it up yourself. So that's a little bit of a bummer. So if you're looking to try and get an even sort of picture in the background, you have to use something that's even going to fit the wall, or you just suffer the consequences. I actually like this room. We did this during my live stream. It was actually all right. And I think that's where the whole black and red thing came from. When I was doing that one, I was like, this is a really cool color palette. But I do have to change it at some point. I just want this to look like, I don't know, I just want the lobby to look nice. I want it to look inviting, but at the same time, where people go, oh, Jeebus, is this a nice place? Yeah, it's a nice place. It just looks a bit gothic-y. All good. Right, let's do the same over here, but with a different picture. So we go for walls, and there we go. So it looks like a picture. It's framed in marble. If I could put like a gold outline around the outside, I really would. But unfortunately, you can't really do that. So there you go. You've got mountains, you've got forest, you've got space, and you've got a abstract painting up there, and a Halloween one in the corner. Yee. Right. Feel like I've broken up the big spaces. It looks like the problem with that bit up there is that because that's part of the hallway, you have to flow the design through yourself into the hallway. You can't do the top layer from the lobby because it's a different level. What's the most expensive, nicest cabinet we can buy right now? A modern day horror, I think this is known as. I don't know, that doesn't look really cool. I mean, that doesn't look any better. That looks all right. I'd say that's more of a centerpiece. So if we pop that there, we can put something above that and that would look all right. And yes, interior designing with hybrid steel. You know when hotels do this, they put like a box next to the window and you don't know why. I think it's just because it breaks up the space. I want to put this somewhere, but I don't know where I want to put it. Actually, you know what? It'll go nicely in this corner because no one's really using this corner. I can imagine this being like a bellhop's desk. Like, you know, the bellhop's going to be standing here, putting stuff away in the drawers, keys, and bits of it. Standing here, oh, okay, I've got a new customer. Walking over here, picking up his bags, and then toddling off up the elevator to, like, death or wherever he's going. I don't know. Right. I think we need a shelf to go up here. I would say that looks all right. As a centerpiece, you put a couple of paintings on the sides. This is your centerpiece. You put your ornaments and bits and pieces. You have a lobby table, sofa, that sort of thing. Right, let's do that. How does this thing... Look, we need to hire an electrician to come in here and figure out why this keeps turning itself off. Just put a bit of sticky tape on the breaker then, would you? Oh, just shut the door. I've got to do my office at some point. It's looking a little bit drab, isn't it? I don't want a painting in here. Right. Okay, painting. That's just tacky. Look, neon lights in this place, that's not going to fly. I think maybe. We don't even have to put a painting. We could just break up the border with bits. This is not a bad idea, actually. I don't know. I don't think gold's a good look on a gold background. I'm not a big fan of this sort of artwork again, but I think it may have to do because it'll fit. Yeah, that looks all right, that. I like it. I like that. Okay. Few decorations. We want a centerpiece. You know, I think we'll represent the old school. Have an old school clock in there. That's fine. There you go. A bookshelf. Right, I need something to go up on top. That looks good. Like, from my point of view, that looks all right. Okie dokie. So, we need 4 chairs or sofas or something that's going to break up, like, being able to sit around for a bit. That looks comfortable. It looks like a lobby chair. So I'm going to put one this side. I want you to sit. Yes, old chap. I was once there. Alright, cool. So I'm going to have the same furniture in the lobby all the way through. Actually, yeah, this is a good one. We can put the sofa. I'm going to put one here and one here. These are for people like... Obviously, this is going to be a restaurant, right? So these are waiting tables. These are waiting chairs. You know, looking at the people, having a chat over the... You know, just general chit-chat. And then they can go in, reservations, so on and so forth. It's all right. All right. Okay, tables. So I need a better table than this. I'm not sure where I want to put this though. I'm trying to think of things logically on where to put a table, why to put it there, that sort of thing. And I mean, there you go. Yeah, that looks all right. Okay, coffee tables. Okay, the coffee tables are what I've just put out. That's fine. Armchairs. So again, we're in a sort of like an open lobby here. I don't really want them to be everywhere. Now, we do have an open policy where you can put stuff out. It's fine. Okay, there's 4 there. That's fine. So again, like, you know, waiting around. It's all good. So I haven't decorated the furniture yet because I haven't chosen the design. I'm going to put one in the corner. Oh, I can't. You know, I want to put one right in there. That'll be the... Hey, so can you wait there a second? Yeah, I can wait here a second. It's fine. Okay. And then, actually, apparently I've got to put a closet in. Oh, I've got some cleaning to do. Okay. Let's go and do some cleaning. There's no cleaning to do. Oh, yeah, there is. There we go. Well, I'm not doing corridor just yet because we're still doing stuff downstairs. Okay, that's fine. We've got seating areas. We've got our bits and pieces. We've left it as open as we can. I don't think I need to put cabinets in. It's not asking me to do cabinets anymore. So I would have thought cabinets we would have been putting behind the desk, considering we need to keep people's stuff safe. You know, and I think we need to go with, like, nice furniture back here because, well, why wouldn't you? So if I put two cabinets there, actually that's not a bad idea for behind there actually. And I'm going to put some shelves above that as well, so we've actually got shelf space. That looks all right. I like that. We're all good. Excellent. Oh, actually, if I put a couple up in here as well. Again, bellhop desk. He's going to want his own little bits and pieces where he keeps his keys, his flannels, his like gloves, all that sort of stuff. He's got his own little place as well. That's cool. Rightio. Okay, we need to put lights in now. So I'm thinking I'm going to keep with this light. I actually don't mind this one too much. It's subtle. And at the same time, it does the job. A little bit better on the old subtle lighting around the edges. Now we need something to go down the middle. And obviously, down the middle. So I need a ceiling lamp. We want this to look a little bit more... I would say we want this to look a bit more sort of... I'm sort of going in this gothic-y way. So it has to be sort of candlelit, but it doesn't... It obviously not real candles. Because I don't want to be burning down my hotel. That looks all right, that. There we go. I would say it looks good, but again, this is just me sort of talking. Okay, so we need another dresser. Oh, yay me. I can't put it next to the front door either. That's the worst part. Would we put a dresser here? Yeah, we'd put a dresser there. It's fine. And we need more shelves, apparently. Well, I like this shelf. Okay, now we need a few more decorations now. So, as we've got these extra shelving parts, we need two more paintings. Is that the best way to put it? Best way to put it? Right there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to break this up a little bit. Actually, I want to put something on this wall as well. So I think we'll go with the same sort of thing, but just in a line instead. There's a cracked pipe in the room. We've got to go and turn the water off. Oh, okay. So even though I know there's a problem in one of the rooms, I can't go and actually do this. I have to go physically upstairs. I have to go and do the cracked pipe, and then I have to go and turn the water off. Okay, water's coming into room 101. Let's go downstairs, go back upstairs, tidy up the room, clean up whilst I'm in here. I can't wait until I unlock the Hoover. Right, I'm back down to, back down to carry on renovating the lobby. Okay, plants. So we need plants now. Plants! So I'm going to put a little plant, like... I'll put a couple of little ones over by the bellhop, you know, because he needs some little beauty stuff to look at as well. Okay, that landed on the floor, so that's not supposed to be there. Right, pick you up in the furniture, plant. Oh, yeah, it sort of fit. That's looking all right, huh? And we've got to put some mirrors in as well. I'm going to put up a vanity mirror next to the restaurant. So, you know when people do that thing where they want to look nice before they go in for food? And they're like there to impress people. So they're going to stand here and go, oh, yes, reservation. Oh, yes, I'm just going to do my eyebrows here. Oh, yeah, look. And then we're going for a reservation. It's all good. Yes. So technology. So I wanted to put up actual TVs dotted around. The reason why is because in some modern places nowadays, they do like their own advertising inside the hotels or like establishments. And it's like you always see like screened televisions of like, their names scrolling by or this, that and the other. And it's like, actually, it's sort of becoming... I think it's becoming more and more mainstream. Also, if you put them above... Maybe. That's not a bad idea. Oh, yeah. So with this, it's like you could sit down here. Your number's like number 27. Your table's ready. It could come up on the screen. Click number 27. Your table's ready. Go to the bar. Or you could order your food. And it's like an automatic tablet. Yeah, this is the sort of thought I put into things. Hello. I don't know. I like this. This is all right, actually. Repair the front desk. I got to press... Ooh, actually, that doesn't half look bad on mine. I know it looked a little bit funny on Diesel's, but that actually looks all right on mine. Excellent. Event. Hiya, we're throwing a bachelorette party for our friend Abigail and would like to stay here for a few days. We need a special room for the bride-to-be. Here's a list of our requirements. Fantastic. I actually quite like this. All right. I'm liking the fact it actually looks pretty. It sort of flows. I don't know if you guys agree. If you do, I'd love to hear your thoughts down in the comment section below. But genuinely, I actually like this. If I walked into this hotel, I'd be like, oh, okay, why isn't that wall painted? Oh, yeah, because the lobby room. But actually not too shabby. So what I want to do up there is I want to repeat this pattern. So the geometry with the bit in the middle up there as well. But I can only do that up there because it has to be done in the corridor. And then I want to follow the black and red through into the hallway so it does flow the rooms and everything else. So that's the other reason why I might change the white bit into black tile along the floor in the actual hallway. But I'm all good with this. All right, guys, if you have enjoyed this video, hit that like, subscribe, notification button below for all other updates. I'll be back here with a brand new video live stream or whatever else is on this channel. Don't forget, I do play this sort of game on a live stream. So if you want to sit there for a little bit longer, talk to me whilst I'm doing all this design work, it'd be appreciated. You know, it's just one of those things I'd love to actually sort of like share with you, because this is one of those things. This is a project that's going to be ongoing, like between videos and live streams. I think I'm going to keep this going. So yeah, I need to fix this. I'm going to do something with here. I'm not sure what you would do here, because this is just like an overhang. Why isn't that floor loaded? And I've got to decorate my furniture. So I'll probably do that in the live stream at some point. But guys, thank you very much for coming by. I'll see you later. I'll say peace out. Have fun. Enjoy everything you guys do. It's much appreciated to have you here. I'll see you later. Fist bump to you.